welcome to Spine Educational Channel. Today we will talk about VFX, particularly when and why should we animate VFX in Spine. I'm Arman, I animate 2D characters for games using Spine. First of all, let me congratulate all of us with the official release of Spine version 4. Calling all developers, please, please guys, update the runtimes. Now, let me answer these questions. Let me actually put them on the screen so you can follow. What means animating VFX in Spine? When you should animate VFX in Spine, when you should not animate VFX in Spine, where you can get ready to use VFX image sequences, and lastly, how to optimize VFX in Spine. Okay, you ready? Then let's answer them one by one. What means animating VFX in Spine? First, VFX stands for visual effects, and animating VFX in Spine means taking already drawn image sequence or just one image and use it in Spine by manipulating it with any available tools Spine offers, like meshes, bones, paths, colors, blending modes, transparency, etc. It is the equivalent of animating VFX for 3D games. In 3D softwares like Blender or Maya, we use sprite sheets for frame-by-frame drawn effects and compose them by combining with other effects. Check this video if you want to see more details on how VFX is done for 3D games. But Spine has major limitations here, compared to 3D softwares. Well, it doesn't work in 3D space, and it doesn't have built-in particle system. Also, textures UV can't be animated. I mean, you can deform the texture, but you can't offset its UV coordinates. The last one is expected soon, according to Nate's comments here. Anyway, there are limitations that can be worked around. For example, we don't have lighting in Spine. We have a very powerful coloring system. And combined with blending modes, we can achieve really rich effects. Warning for programmers, blending modes used in Spine may affect performance for some game engines by increasing locals. Okay, I will leave the link to the VFX playlist we have done previously so you can see work in progress. I think I've answered first question. Let's see when you should animate VFX in Spine. Do it in Spine if the effect is integrated with the character, something that is unique to it, or you want to soften quick transitions with motion blur. Show the flow of the movement using speed lines. Maybe add more integration with the environment by adding dust on the ground when character falls. Sometimes VFX should appear sandwiched between character's layers, which is hard to do in the game engine, so animate it in Spine. Moving to the next question, which is when you should not animate VFX in Spine. Don't try to animate a lot of particles using multiple bones. It really doesn't worth the cost. Takes too much time and heavy for performance. And even if you do, separate particles into groups. It will reduce the bone counts. If effect appears on more than one character in the game, maybe the character is frozen and ice crystals should appear over it. Better to animate it in the game engine directly, to be able to reuse it over the rest characters. If effect doesn't belong to the character or has dynamic behavior such as casting a fireball, do it in the game engine, or at least create a separate Spine project for that VFX, since you don't know the trajectory of that fireball beforehand. The image assets that VFX is using will be packed in the final atlas, so they should not take too much space. I would normally allocate 60% of the atlas for character and 40% for VFX. Some VFX can be easily done in the game engine, by shaders or pre-made particles. I mean, don't animate water surface in the Spine if you can find shader for it, and use it all over the environment. That way it will look consistent. With shaders you can incorporate global wind and lighting, which would be much harder to achieve in Spine. Actually, let me quickly show the spreadsheet of this project.
Yeah, definitely can be optimized. Stay with me to see how we can do it.
And next, we are answering to what to do if you already decided to go with spine, but you don't have drawing skills and don't know where to find image assets for VFX. Well, you can buy pre-made libraries and use them according to the license. Go create some effects using particle systems such as Unity has. Then export it as transparent PNG sequence and import into the spine. Or maybe buy Unity pre-made particles. Much cheaper and more variety. Again, you will need to export these effects from Unity as a PNG sequence. Spine cannot read any Unity related assets. You also can use video footage with chroma key. Just clean it in Photoshop, add some spice to it, such as filters or adjustment layers. Generally, I would edit one frame in Photoshop. Save modifications as an action. Bind it to a key and play that action on the remaining frames. Finally, let's cover optimization. I did another video covering these tips in details. Here, putting the link on the screen. Generally, you need to cut as much effects as possible. Remove not important in-betweens. Reduce the size of the images right before it becomes unacceptable. And remember to compromise those reductions in spine. For instance, blurry images look good when blending mode set to additive. Overlapping two exact image sequences with one frame delay can make it look smooth. Maybe you can avoid using sequence at all. Just use meshes to animate smooth deformations. Anyway, check this video for more examples. We'll see you in the next video. Thank you, guys.